Federalism is a system of government where the power is divided between a central authority and various constituent units of the country. Decentralization is the essence of federalism, having a system of multi-unit government and the multi-level planning. It devolves powers, functions, authority, and finance to different levels of the government. Each of the constituent units in its own sphere coordinates with each other and within themselves, and each of which acts directly on the people through its administrative machinery. The states in a federation are heterogeneous as they differ in climate, physical features, language, customs, institutions, and religion. They all display a common feature, a union of heterogeneous states. The government could be unitary or federal. The unitary form of government is different from that of the federal form. In a unitary form of government, there exists only one government with numerous administrative units under the direct control of the government. In the federal system of the government, the central government is the sovereign authority, and there are numerous units of government under the center. Though there is a marked difference between the federal and the unitary form of governments, the general principles of public finance are applicable to both equally. In India, the framers of the Constitution described it as federal union or quasi-federal setup. In several aspects, the unitary elements have clearly overshadowed the federal attributes, with the center assuming more dominating role than what even the constitution makers has visualized. In a federal system, there are three levels of government governing the same citizens, but each level has its own jurisdiction, legislative, judiciary, and financial powers. The top level is the central or the union government, and below it lays the level of state governments and then local governments, such as municipalities and panchayats. Below the states, there are local governments, both in the urban and the rural areas, as we have mentioned, municipalities and panchayats. The statutory recognition to rural and urban local governments in India was introduced in 1992 with the 73rd and 74th constitutional amendments. In this module, we will discuss in detail the principles of multi-unit finance.
After studying this module, you shall be able to know the federal setup, understand different principles of multi-unit finance. Federalism is a system of government where the power is divided between a central authority and various constituent units of the country. Decentralization is the essence of federalism, having a system of multi-unit government and multi-level planning. It devolves power, functions, authority, and finance to different levels of the government. The government could be unitary or federal. The unitary form of government is different from that of the federal form. Under unitary form of government, there exists only one government, under which there are numerous administrative units under the direct control of the government. Under the federal system of the government, the central government is the sovereign authority, and there are numerous units of government under the center. Though there is a marked difference between the federal and unitary form of governments, the general principles of public finance are applicable to both equally well. In India, the framers of Constitution described it as federal union or quasi-federal setup. There are three levels of government governing the same citizens, but each level has its own jurisdiction, legislative, judiciary, and financial powers. The top level is the central or union government, and below it lays the level of state government and then the local governments. Below the states, there are local governments, both in urban and rural areas. Each set of governments have to perform certain functions for which they need finance. An overarching institutional framework had emerged in India to deal with center-state financial relations. The federal government and the regional government claim independent and adequate resources of revenue for the functioning of their respective governments. Thus, the three levels of government need coordination and central intervention for sufficient solutions. It is therefore necessary that different means of finance should be divided in such a way that each unit or government gets an equitable share.
Each set of governments have to perform certain functions for which they need finance. Arun Bhargav says, federal finance means the finance of the central government as well as the states and the relationship between the two. According to the provisions of the Constitution, the sources of revenue and items of expenditure or functions are clearly defined and distributed among the center, states and the local bodies. It describes the legislative, executive and judicial powers of the center and the states through the union, state and the current lists. These lists are first the union list. The union list exclusively under the central government relates to the functions of national importance like defense, atomic energy, external affairs, communications, constitution, organization of the Supreme Court and the High Courts, elections, currency, finance and exchange, foreign and interstate trade, and basic industries, etc. The state lists, exclusively under the state governments, looks into the life and welfare of the people, such as public law and order, local administration, education and public health, fisheries, rural development, including agriculture, etc. The concurrent list is under the purview of both the center and the state governments. It includes forests, economic planning, population and family planning, commercial monopolies, labor disputes, education and social legislation, etc. Finance is an important aspect of federal government. The sources of revenue of the central and the state governments are different, and the deficit states are aided by the central government. An overarching institutional framework has emerged in India to deal with the center-state financial relations. The sources of finance were identified, and the critical institutions that are intermediate between the center, state and the local bodies are Finance Commission, which is a constitutional body, the Planning Commission, the Interstate Council, the National Development Council and the State Finance Commissions. Financial disputes between the center and the states and among the states are resolved constitutionally. The state governments have administrative autonomy on many functions but are subordinate to the center. The federal government and the regional governments claim independent and adequate resources of revenue for the functioning of their respective governments. Thus, the three levels of government need coordination and central intervention for efficient solutions. It is therefore necessary that different means of finance should be divided in such a way that each unit or government gets an equitable and adequate share. The financial autonomy is maintained between the center and the states through sharing of taxes, grants in aid and loans, and is vital to the preservation of the federal principle.
The main principles of federal finance are the principles of independence and responsibility, the principle of adequacy and elasticity, the principle of administrative economy, the principle of efficiency, the principle of uniformity, the principle of equity, and the principle of integration and coordination. Let us now start with principle of independence and responsibility. Financial independence and responsibility are the two main requisites for the success of fiscal federalism. The different units of the government of a federal state should be fully independent in matters of its financial affairs. They should be autonomous in their financial matters and should also be responsible to raise the resources for meeting its expenditure obligations. If the country is big with multi-diverse states, but the communities within the state might be homogeneous, the state government should have the freedom to vary the scale of their tax effort and supply of public services.
If the country is big with multi-diverse states, but the communities within the state might be homogeneous, the state governments should have the freedom to vary the scale of their tax effort and supply of public services. States are usually not in a position to raise adequate revenues on a scale necessary to perform constitutional functions. They resort to central assistance through devolution of tax revenues or grants under federal finance. This entails dependence of the state governments on the center. No state should be allowed to spend money in a manner prejudicial to the national interests. The center would lay down norms and rules of expenditure, and the state governments would be accountable to the federal government. Professor Adharkar said that full freedom of financial operations must be extended to both federal as well as state governments in order that they may not suffer from a feeling of cramp in the discharge of their normal activities and in the achievement of their legitimate aspirations for the promotion of social and economic advancement. Thus, financial independence and responsibility are two main requisites for the success of fiscal federalism. The different units of the government of a federal state should be fully independent in matters of its financial affairs. They should be autonomous in their financial matters and should also be responsible to raise resources for meeting its expenditure obligations.
The principle of adequacy and elasticity. Adequacy implies sufficient resources for the center and the states in order to maintain certain standards of administration and perform the fiscal functions in their own spheres. The tax coverage and tax schedules should not discriminate citizens residing in different states. Financial elasticity is an important device to reconcile autonomy and inadequacy of resources of the state governments. When functions and resources are divided between the different units of the government, the more elastic and productive sources of revenue with nation base tend to be allocated to the center and less elastic with immobile and localized base to the lower levels of the government.
State must have adequate revenue to discharge its various expenditure responsibilities. According to Seligman, the three principles that should guide in the allocation of revenue among various tax jurisdictions are the extent of the base of the system, the efficiency of the administration, and the adequacy of revenue. The tax coverage and the tax schedules should not discriminate citizen residing in different states. In case of conflict or competition in the assignment of functions to different governments, the financial adequacy is sought to be adjusted through intergovernmental resources. When functions and resources are divided between the different units of the government, the more elastic and productive sources of revenue with nation base tend to be allocated to the center, and less elastic with immovable and localized base to the lower levels of the government. The financial system should be elastic. That implies the expansion of resources in the sources of revenue. It should not be so rigid as to render any change in it very difficult. The financial system should be so devised to meet the changing needs of the government concerned. There are certain emergencies like war and natural calamities like floods, famines, earthquakes, where more money is needed. The financial system, therefore, is so designed so as to enable the government concerned to obtain more income during the periods of crisis. Dr. Bhargav remarks, the scheme of division of resources must set up an elastic system, because no scheme, howsoever good, can be final for all times to come. Under changing conditions, any arrangement is bound to be out of date in the course of time and requires revision. The scheme of division must therefore incorporate provisions for such changes when they become necessary in the national interest.
Principle of administrative economy. Administrative economy is the important principle of federal finance. In a federation, the different units of government should optimize national welfare through the process of division of powers and responsibilities, and also by coordinating their activities. The financial system should be so designed and administered as to leave no scope of tax evasion or fraud. Maximum economy and minimum cost should be affected in the collection of taxes. If large amount is spent in the collection of taxes, the purpose of imposing tax would be defeated to a large extent. Double or multiple taxation should be avoided.
Let us now discuss principle of efficiency. The division of tax and other financial powers between the center and the states has to be decided consistently with the responsibilities assigned to the two levels of government under the Constitution. There are various duties and functions which can be more efficiently provided only at a federal level, while there are others which are best provided at the state or local level. There exists a large gap between the amount spent and the amount raised. It is likely to lead to inefficient utilization of resources. The loss of economic efficiency may arise if states are granted the power to levy certain kind of taxes. In general, if the rates of tax and the levels of benefit vary among the states, the factors of production will be induced to change their location. There will be full mobility of capital and labor. Therefore, substantial differences in the rates of certain taxes would lead to artificial diversion of investment to low tax areas and may also induce labor to shift from one region to another. Thus, the tax structure should be neutral in their effects on the neighboring regions.
the principle of equity. The ideal allocation of resources between the center and the states should be in accordance with the principle of minimum needs for the people living in different state. This can be achieved through transfer of resources from rich areas to poor areas in a federal state. The basic reason for these transfers is to reduce interstate inequalities of income. It must be remembered that vast inequalities in distribution of income between people living in various states is not conducive to the prosperity of a nation. The principle of uniformity. The central government should see that uniform treatment is meted out to every state and there is no partiality with any state. Every state should receive equitable and just share of the benefit and also should share the equal burden. The center should follow the policy of equal responsibility and equal welfare towards every state. The principle of integration and coordination. Despite evolving a scheme of division of functions and finances, there are bound to be a tax and expenditure overlapping which require coordination and harmonization of policies of expenditure and taxation of different levels of government. It is of utmost importance that national integrity, unity, and character must not be jeopardized in any way. The budgetary policies of the state government must be in conformity with the central government budgetary policy. Otherwise, the integrated economic development of a country as a whole will not be possible. In this module, you have learnt about federal setup in India. Financial independence and responsibility are the two main requisites for the success of fiscal federalism. The different units of government should have adequate resources of revenue for the functioning of their respective government and should be capable of expansion with growing needs. The financial system should be designed and administered economically. There should be uniformity in tax structure and equal treatments should be meted out for all the states. It is therefore necessary that different means of finance should be divided in such a way that each unit or government gets an equitable share. In a federation, the different units of government should optimize national welfare through a process of division of powers and responsibilities and also by coordinating their activities.